we got out of the house, flames started coming out the back door.
A house catches fire in Amelia with 8 people inside, several of them children. Good evening, everyone, and thanks for joining us. I'm Curtis Fuller. Everyone inside escaped without injury, and tonight we're learning it was all thanks to 2 Good Samaritans. The fire started just after 8 o'clock this morning on West Main Street in Amelia. News 5's Laura Borcher spoke to the local heroes in a story you're seeing new tonight.
This morning, 2 men driving down Route 125 saw smoke coming from this home. They jumped into action, and because they did, they saved 8 lives.
We seen a little smoke pouring out of the top of the roof, and he said, that smoke don't look right, so we made a U-turn around in the middle of the street, and by the time we got back, it was fully engulfed with flame, and we started knocking on the side door.
And I went around the front.
I punched the window in the other one. About that time, we got them up.
I kicked the door in. We finally did get them out.
8 family members, including a 3-year-old and a 2-month-old baby, battled through smoke, grappling to find their way out.
Right after we got out of the house, flames started coming out the back door.
After escaping, one of the family members turned around and shot this cell phone video. You can actually hear sparks shooting off the wall that held an electrical box. The century-old home was consumed quickly. Now it's declared a complete loss. As firefighters battled the blaze, Good Samaritans Terry Lovell and Ed Powers helped direct traffic around the closed-down Main Street. Fire officials have said there were no working smoke detectors, and without Ed and Terry, this fire would have been deadly.
They would have never woke up. The fire was moving very quickly throughout the entire house.
Just lucky we was at the right place at the right time, and I'd do it 100 times over if I had to.
Well, I got grandbabies myself, too, and I'd want someone to do the same thing for me.
When I seen them start coming out of there, you know, not dressed and in diapers, a lot of things went through my mind, you know, just thank God they got out and they were safe.
The Stewart family did not have insurance, so the few items they've been able to salvage from the home are now all that they have. They do have a family member who runs the Stewart Shoe Repair Shop on Beachmont Avenue. They're going to be accepting donations there tomorrow. I'm Laura Borchers, News 5.